Hi, this is Devin Lockett from BiomedRx TV, and today we're going to be discussing zeolite. Zeolite, also known as clinoptilolite, is a mineral that is formed when molten volcanic lava hits seawater. Because of this unique condition, the minerals in the seawater bind to the lava and transform it into a particular cage shape, molecular cage shape, and it gives it a negative magnetic charge. Just like the negative magnetic charge that is found in bentonite clay that I made a video about a week ago. This makes zeolite uniquely qualified as a detoxification agent for heavy metals such as mercury, aluminum, and lead. The ability of zeolites to lose and gain water reversibly and also to exchange cations, in other words, maintain its negative charge and attract heavy metal toxins without losing its cage-like structure, is what gives zeolite its unique property as a molecular sieve. When I first opened the BiomedRx Health Center, I was focused on helping my son overcome autism. Now, there's a lot of controversy out there surrounding the causes of autism and whether autism is being caused by vaccines. The controversy is really around thimerosal, which is a form of mercury that is used to preserve vaccines. Here recently, the medical establishment is saying that children are no longer given thimerosal preserved vaccines and that the vaccines are safe. But pretty routinely, people have found that children on the autism spectrum have high levels of mercury. Mercury is a serious neurotoxin. The damage that comes from mercury is incredible. In my experience as a biomedical equipment maintenance technician in the United States Air Force, we were often tasked with cleaning up mercury spills, mercury that had spilled from mercury sphygmomanometers and from other medical equipment. Mercury is a very dangerous neurotoxin that has to be handled very carefully. If you take mercury and you store it the way you're supposed to store it, which is inside of a glass jar under a certain level of water, sealed up with the jar taped up inside of a plastic Ziploc bag, you will find that after storing mercury this way, the inside of the plastic bag is going to look like chrome after a few months. In other words, mercury vapors will have seeped through the water, through the glass, and stuck to the inside of the plastic bag. This is how caustic mercury vapors are. We're all familiar with the children's story, Alice in Wonderland. One of the characters in the story is called the Mad Hatter. The Mad Hatter comes from an old expression when people would suffer from mental illness. They would say, he is as mad as a hatter. This phrase went on for centuries before people realized that hat makers suffered insanity as an occupational hazard because they were using mercury to bend the felt. And the mercury vapors would get into the bloodstream through the nose. And mercury, once it's introduced to the blood, is going to try to recongeal. I know we all remember when we were children that if someone broke a thermometer, that we would sit around and play with the mercury. That's actually quite dangerous. It's a very dangerous thing to do. And when you breathe in the mercury vapors, mercury is going to try to recongeal. Just like when you play with mercury on a table, the mercury will try to clump back up into a one solid lump. Well, the mercury is going to try to regroup when it's in your bloodstream, and the only place for it to regroup is inside the soft tissue in the brain. So, needless to say, mercury is an incredibly toxic substance for the brain. It's a terrible neurotoxin. If you have mercury in your bloodstream, it's going to be very toxic to your brain in the short term and in the long term. But besides mercury, we are also exposed to many other environmental metals and toxins. We're exposed to rat poison, insecticides, aluminum, arsenic, the things that they found in the chemtrails that are being sprayed above us, barium, I believe it is, manganese, lots of different very toxic heavy metals. Although heavy metals such as thimerosal, used as a preservative, are no longer used on the vaccines given to children, there's no guarantee that thimerosal is not being used as a preservative on vaccines that are being given to adults. And in today's health climate, it is very likely that we are going to be presented with a vaccine pretty soon that adults are going to be expected to take. In a previous video, I discussed bentonite clay, which is a very good chelating agent for removing heavy metals from the body. I also did a video about diatomaceous earth. Although it is not a chelator of heavy metals per se, it is a very good cleanser for the digestive system and for the entire body. Well, zeolite is a little bit of both. Once again, because of its unique cage-like structure, zeolite is able to trap heavy metals such as lead, cadmium, and mercury and remove them from the body. And because of cation exchange, because of the negative magnetic charge that zeolite has, it's also able to trap and remove free radicals from the body. Now, once again, before I start talking about the health benefits of zeolite, I have to stress that I am not a doctor, and nothing that you see on BiomedRx TV should be construed as medical advice in any way. However, zeolite has been known to help cleanse the liver and also the digestive tract, raise the body's antioxidant levels, binding mycotoxins, forming stable complexes, stabilizing and regulating the immune system, bind unwanted toxins in the digestive tract before they are absorbed into the body, pollutant binding and cleansing, alkalizes the body by providing alkalizing minerals and supporting kidney function, removes heavy metal toxins such as lead, cadmium, and mercury, and promotes a healthy gut. The kind of zeolite that you would have to take for, I guess you could say, medicinal purposes or for health purposes would be clinoptilolite. Anyone can take zeolite, men, women, children, and you could take it 2 or 3 times a day. The detoxification begins instantly. Zeolite will begin to clean your body the minute you take it, and you won't have what is called a Herxheimer's effect or a healing crisis, because the zeolite never loses its crystalline cage shape. Zeolite is definitely one of the holistic health products that you should have, basically just to maintain good health, keep your body alkaline, and to keep your body detoxed of heavy metals. But you should take a little bit of zeolite liquid under the tongue every day and allow it to absorb into your body. If you have a particular heavy metal toxin burden or any type of detoxification that you would like to take place, you should take zeolite about 2 to 3 times a day. And then once you have taken care of that toxin, you should reduce it to once a day. Well, that's all I have to say about zeolite for this video. If you like this video, please remember to hit the like button and comment and share and subscribe to BiomedRx TV. If you would like to have full access to all of our training videos, become a patron on Patreon at patreon.com/BiomedRxTV. And remember, I would like everyone to stay kind, because kind is the new sexy. Stay blessed and stay healthy. Thank you for watching BiomedRx TV.